All right, everybody, today we're doing a full walk around my new Aston Martin V8 4.7 liter 420 horsepower with 361 pounds of torque. I really love the hood vents and the carbon fiber accents. It definitely has a look like no other car. A couple other things to note. Alloy wheels. Recessed door handles. Another thing I like is the trunk. So this button here opens the trunk, and it's actually big. There's a power port in here, first aid kit, Aston Martin umbrella that comes with all Aston Martins, because since they are built in London, it's rainy there. So they all come with that. I like the carbon fiber and halogen lights, front parking sensors. Also has rear parking sensors, rear view camera, dual exhaust, of course. She's got quite the sound to her. Let's take a look at the inside. Something to notice about the doors, they open upward at an angle. So you can pull up to low curbs and not have to worry about hitting the curb. I actually wish my Caddy did that, because my Cadillac sits even lower than this thing does. So, very nice touch. Getting in it, we've got obsidian black interior with white stitching. Something to notice, the emergency brake is here on the left side. But when it's engaged, it also lays flat, so it doesn't cause a problem getting in and out. First thing you notice in here is the center stack and the piano black finish. Very classy, very nice. Transmission is all on buttons, drive, neutral, reverse, sport mode. This is your push to start, which you actually have to insert the, what they call the emotion control unit, which looks like this. I'll show you that here in a minute. It has a 6-disc changer, satellite radio. It also has aux in, USB in, iPod connection. It has one power port here. It also has another power port here. And in here is also the connections for the Bluetooth, or for the USB and aux. So this is the key. It's also the fob. And you insert it into the middle. And what I like is when you do insert it, it pops up in on the display unit here and says pure Aston Martin. So I do like the room that I have behind me for a bag, Mandy's purse. There's enough room here to, you know, set a small, even maybe a small carry-on suitcase, which my Cadillac does not have. There is no room in the Cadillac when the top is up or down. It is a very tight, tight ride. So we will start it up here, foot on the brake. GPS comes up, also has a rear view camera. And when you start it, I'm not sure if you'll see it say it, but it is pure Aston Martin. One thing that I miss is the heads-up display. My Cadillac has a heads-up display that projects speed, radio station that I'm on, or CD track. Also shows me what gear I'm in when I'm shifting. This doesn't have that. It only has the center area here. This is the 7-speed sport shift transmission with the paddles. Very, very sensitive. It's very track ready. Really feels like a race car. It also comes in a manual, but I decided to go with the 7-speed. The manual is only a 6-speed, and I do like the paddle shifters. They're very nice. Drove it back from Phoenix, 500 miles about, and well, maybe 400 miles. It was a great drive. She runs just as good on the freeway as she does on the street. So that is my new baby, my Aston Martin. Cameron calls her Nigel after the Aston Martin in Cars, movie Cars by Disney. Fast, very luxurious. All right, hope you enjoyed.